Hi guys, welcome back to my Java tutorials video. In this tutorial, I'll talk about what is hybrid inheritance. So far, we have seen the examples for what is single level, multi-level and hierarchy. Now let's understand what is hybrid. Hybrid means combination of any of them, like a single level, multi-level and hierarchy, instead of one specific inheritance. Now let's see A, B, D. This is a multi-level. If you can see A, B, C, this is again hierarchy. So we have combination of two inheritances here. That's why this one is called as a hybrid inheritance. In our example, car class, we have Honda and Audi is again hierarchy inheritance, and we have one more called as Civic model. This extends to Honda extends to car. This one is multi-level. The same thing I'm showing in a real-time example. That's it. We'll see this coding example in the tutorial as well.
Suppose we have car class here, Honda extends car here. This is a single level inheritance. And class Civic extends Honda. This one is multi-level inheritance, right? Suppose we have class Audi extends car. You don't have this one, these three called as multi-level. Suppose if you don't have this one, these three called as hierarchy. If you don't have these two called as single level. Depends on our requirement, we can give the access to any of the classes using this hybrid inheritance. Whatever is there inside the car class, this Honda and Audi can access it because this extends the car class. So let's create instance variable here instead of methods, just for a change. Int is equal to 50. This one int h equal to 100. This is, let's say, cc. Int cc equal to 150. Int, let's say, a equals to 200. First, let's have a main method, public static void main, that create a object for civic class first. Civic dot. Look, we can access these three, C, CC and H. We can access H. So in this, we cannot access this Audi variable, except this one, we can access these three variables, right? That is the main advantage of creating and having these many inheritances. You can also give access to some of the methods instead of creating again. These and all advantages of having inheritance. We also have one disadvantage, that is the dependency, because one class is depends on the other class. So if you want to access those class objects, again you have to create one object and access them. That is the only disadvantage here. If you run the code, pretty much you can access these three variables. That's all for today's topic, guys. I hope you enjoy watching my videos. See you in my next video. Stay tuned and happy learning.